Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me much pleasure, much humility, and a great honour to pay this short tribute to those three Fusiliers from the 1st Battalion, the Royal Highland Fusiliers. This tribute to Privates John McCaig, Joseph McCaig, and Dougal McGawkey. These were the three Scottish soldiers who were lured near this spot and so callously and brutally murdered at almost this very place on the 9th of March 1971 by the killers of the Irish Republican Army, the enemies of our beloved Ulster. They were the first members of the security forces to be killed whilst off duty, but sadly were not to be the last, as yesterday evening in Antrim showed us only too well. Two of them, Privates John McCaig and his brother Joseph, were amongst the youngest military casualties of the entire murderous terrorist campaign waged by rampant republicanism against the British state here in Ulster. They were shot in the head as they stood here together on this lonely mountain road, faithful even until death. And although it was widely assumed that they were lured from the centre of Belfast by those evil people who defended and then ultimately betrayed them, the inquest in 1971 was told that the full and exact details of what happened that day were not known and may never be fully known. Their bodies were found by children playing on this hillside who alerted adults, and the very ambulance driver who came to them whilst Dougal McGawkey was taking his last breath, we are pleased to say, is with us here today. You would rightly think that this was not only murder, but one of the vilest crimes ever perpetrated here. But sadly, this was not to be the case, as more and more horrors were inflicted upon us over the many long years of terror that we all endured, and that we will never forget, and that we will never allow to be forgotten. We are gathered here today to commemorate this anniversary of the foul deed, and to give thanks to Almighty God for the short but useful lives of these three young men of the Royal Highland Fusiliers, who are now in his keeping. And so, as we express our deep sense of gratitude, for they died for us, we think of their families and their comrades, again, some of which are with us here today. They died so that we may live here in our beloved Ulster, in the faith and loyalty that we have always known. And I indulge you, if I may, to just stand for a moment longer whilst I read to you a few verses of the tribute in a poem that was penned by an unknown Ulster poet all those years ago. All those that rule this province, how guilty they must feel for the deaths of the three young soldiers in this ditch at Laganale. These soldiers came from Scotland, two only in their teens. In cold blood they were murdered, whilst those in power dreamed. When our own Ulster soldiers, some serving far away, receive their sprig of shamrock, I wonder what they'll say. Our land's good name is tarnished, this scar will never heal. Perhaps they'll plant a thistle in this ditch at Laganale. It matters not how long they live, they never can conceal. They stood aside while soldiers died in this ditch at Laganale. Our thoughts go to their parents when on their knees they kneel and try to paint the picture of this place called Laganale, lest we forget.
The Court of the Royal Highland Fusiliers. Regimental Court. Almighty God, who did so bless the endeavours of our fathers that they have handed down to us an example of heroism and sacrifice, grant, we beseech you, to the Royal Highland Fusiliers, that assaults of evil, and inspire us so to serve thee in our day and generation, that we may be worthy of all the trust which has been committed to us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
To be laid will be laid by John Vicker, a member of the Old Park Cahill branch, and this will be laid on behalf of the family who we are in touch with and who we hope will be joining us here next year to celebrate or commemorate the actual dedication of the death.